What is going on, guys? This is a 2020 F250 Super Duty. It does have a 6.7, but the reason we're making the video is for the blind spot and cross traffic system fault. If you're getting these messages, 9 times out of 10 you will need a module, or there are certain scenarios like what I'm dealing with where the customer had new headlights installed, but the modules that were in the new headlights were incorrect for the vehicle, so they will have to be so we had to put the old ones back in and reinstall them, and most likely reprogram, maybe just plug them in, but we're gonna plug them in and see what happens. So here's the serial number. It's kind of rubbed off, but you can see right there where it says SN. I mean, a lot of these numbers are different, but I'm gonna go off the serial number. This is the one that came out of the truck originally. This is the one that somebody else put in. And you see the serial numbers are just completely different. 012211. So make sure you have the right serial number. This part number on the housing right there, that will be the same, because that's a part number for the housing. That's not a part number for the module. So make sure you're putting the same module back in. This thing wasn't a wreck, so these may not work, but we're gonna plug them in, reprogram, and see how it goes. So far, I went into the side object detection module, went into special functions, come in here, it wants to verify the VIN. The reason it's verifying the VIN is to match it up with the right part number. If you have a different module back there than what is made for this VIN, it's not gonna work. That's the issue this time. If that's not your issue, you need a new module, and then you have to do this. Says switch, set ignition switch to off, turn it off, let it do its thing. Says turn it back on. It's reading data from original module. Saves it, turn it off, then we're going to be done. We're going to write data. It's going to say install a new module in the vehicle, but we're just going to pretend we did. Turn it on. It's going to be this one. Yesterday I was trying to do this with a different part number before I realized they had swap parts. So I have two files on here. If you're just going through and doing this, you should only have one. I'm going to click the one I just did just now. Writing it. Set ignition to off, okay. Set it to on, okay. Side object detection module, left side complete. I'm gonna go through and do the right side. If you wanna see me do the right side, it's gonna be the same process. If you wanna see me do it, stick around. I'm gonna back out because it's a whole different, this is the left side. Go to the right side, obstacle detection control module, go right here. ECU needs to be determined, okay.
Oh shit, turn this back on. ECU needs to be determined. Functional test, special functions, programmable module, ensure ignition switch is on and not running. Yes, we are. And I'm just running through and doing the same thing. So this will be the same process you would have to do if you installed a new one. You would need the old one, pull the data off of it, write it to the new one so that it knows this is gonna work. Off position. We're gonna read the data. Basically the scanner right now thinks I'm installing a new one, but it's the same one. Not installing a new one. Can you do this without this scanner? I think you can do it with an Altel scanner, as long as you have a newer one. This is just what we carry at the shop, the Snap-on Modus Edge, but I do believe I've heard of people doing it with the aftermarket scanner. This is an aftermarket scanner, but I do believe you can do it with Altels as well. You won't be able to do it with some very basic generic scanner. You're not going to be able to save or write any data. You're not going to be able to do that. But with the newer ones, yes, you can. SODR module configuration data saved successfully. Switch it to off. Hit OK. Write data in new module. Install new module in vehicle. Yes. Switch your ignition back on. OK. We're writing the module. Writing the data, the old data to the new module. Off and back on. SODR module configuration complete. Okay. Switch it to off. Okay. Now, let's see what we got when we fire this bad boy up here. I saw the messages we were getting before. Vehicle's on. Driver door ajar. Ajar. Vehicle. I don't understand. The vehicle's on, and our messages are gone. I didn't clear any codes or anything. You may have to. I'm just saying I didn't clear any codes. But after I reprogrammed those modules to this VIN, it's all good to go. And this is on a 2020 F350. So. Hopefully that helps you guys out. If it did, please hit that like and subscribe button, man. I'm going to give you guys as much as I possibly can. So, hey, I really appreciate you guys tuning in. If you have this problem, I hope it helps. Like I said, this is a special case where the customer put some new ones in. They didn't know what they were doing. But if that's not the scenario, then you're probably going to need a new module. Just telling you up front, that's how they make them now. So, hey, thanks for tuning in, man. You guys be good. This is your Blue Collar Mechanic.